If you like my dad's videos, please subscribe to QA Insights channel.
Hi, welcome back. A couple weeks ago, Neotis has released its newer version of NeoLoad. The version is 6.7. I'm an ardent user of LoadRunner. I've worked on NeoLoad quite a little bit of time, but in my leisure time, I'll try to learn other tools other than LoadRunner and JMeter. I'll try to focus on other tools. So in this video, I'm going to cover what's new in NeoLoad 6.7, mostly from the practical point of view. The key selling point in this release is shift left and shift right. So as you know, shift left means you need to start your testing very early in the lifecycle, and you need to test very often, and you need to test continuously. So these are the three objective of shift left. So in this release, they are focusing on the performance test as a code, which means assume that you have a project which uses the APIs extensively. And if you want to involve performance testing as early as possible, what you can do is you can get the Swagger file from the QA team or from the dev team, and you can import it directly to NeoLoad, and you can change the endpoints and start testing. So this is one of the most important feature in this NeoLoad 6.7. And if you just scroll down, they have already published the webinar about the 6.7. I suggest you to go through it. It's 35 minutes of duration. So that is the first key feature in this release. So as you know here, test often, early, and as code. So these are the three DevOps shift left strategy. And okay, now I'll just open NeoLoad. I just downloaded. I had the previous version. This is the latest one. And if you go to file under new, we'll just create a new project, say test. And in the landing page, it will ask whether you want to start recording or you want to open the API using the import button. So let us open one Swagger YAML file. So I already downloaded the Swagger YAML from this website, editor.swagger.io, HTTPS, and you can go to file menu and save as YAML, okay? Now go to your import open API dialog box and click on import. So what it will do is it will import everything in the whatever details available in the YAML, and then it will automatically categorize for you. So right now under the action folder, we have three, pet, store, and users. So everything is parameterized, only you have to change the value, and then you can start your test. And whenever you want to add some assertions, checkpoints, whatever you want to add, you can do it. And also there are a lot of options in the actions here, if loop, while loop, if condition, loop, while, etc. So you can use these in the code like this. So it's pretty straightforward, pretty simple. It will definitely, it will expedite your performance testing as a code, and also very early you can start testing. Even you can test smoke test your QA endpoint, you can smoke test your dev environment, whatever environment you have, you can just change the endpoint, you can run it, whatever license available in your organization, based on that you can inject the load. So that is one key feature in the NeoLoad 6.7. And when it comes to shift right, okay, just scroll down. So shift right means it's the one of the strategy where you will wait for testing to be happened in the production or pre-build or in the UAT, we can say. So by exposing this level of testing to production or just before production, you will get a new different kind of test cases, scenarios basically. So for example, user interface, the load wise, performance wise, security wise. So this is the shift right. Mainly performance monitoring plays an important role. So if you want to have shift right, you can have the enhanced APM integration with the AppDynamics in the NeoLoad 6.7. So this the integration is available in the Neotis lab. So you can just check this link about the details. So these are the two key features they have listed. And another important feature from my perspective is you can say load runner script converter. So as you know, I think I have posted a video about load runner script converter using Neoload, which is open source. But now you can use this tool. If you go to tools and click on script converter, you'll get a wizard like this, and you need to associate the directory where you have stored your load runner scripts. And then if you click on next, it will automatically convert to Neotis Neoload project. And in this version, they have covered a lot of functions for the WebHTTP HTML. So that is one of the key points here. So they have, I think, more than 10 to 15 functions. It will convert from load runner to Neoload project. So if you go to this GitHub link, you can see the list of functions which is supported. Just scroll down. Okay, see here, starting from WebBridge Find to WebLink. So these are the functions it is now supported. And also if you check the SAP GUI, so it supports SAP GUI also. And also it will support these LR functions and these string and numeric functions, and also this selection statements and parameters. And what is not covered is these are not covered. So these are the some of the things will not work if you're trying to convert to Neoload project. So that is another feature where you want to focus in this newer version. And I am not an expert in SAP GUI. So again, if you see SAP GUI load testing faster and more scalable because of the greater scalability, and we can convert the SAP GUI scripts from load runner to Neoload project. So, and also other features we can check it out here. One of the key is here, launch test through Neoload web using Docker based Neoload controllers. If you can deploy controllers for the Neoload using the Docker. So you can go to this hub.docker.com/r/neotis, and you can use this pull command to deploy the controller as a Docker. So that's it. So please explore if you are a Neoload expert you are just getting started with Neoload. Please download the latest version. Again, it is free. You will get 50 users for test, which covers all most of the protocols. So please do download, and you will get the license key in the email, and you can upload it in the Neoload. So that's it, guys, from my side. If you have any questions, please let me know in the comments. Otherwise, please feel free to go to my next lecture. Thank you. Have a great day.
If you like my dad's videos, please subscribe to QA Insights channel.